save people on the interwebs. Yeah, they're in. Going here. Figure out what we're doing here. Okay. Okay. I'm trying to batten down the hatches here, man. Just get everything right before I sit down. Y'all just watch that sky. Y'all tell me if a tornado drops out of there. Y'all let me know. You see a tornado yet? Anybody? Nobody's here? Nobody see the tornado yet? Hey, Sydney, how you doing, buddy? Might be my last broadcast, man. They're telling us to take shelter, baby. Take shelter. I do that from time to time, over by the house. I'm tired of these damn storms trying to dictate when and where I can work. They starting to get on my last damn nerve. I'm fixing the meat and potatoes here, man. Give me a second. It's a little bit more detailed than I thought it was gonna be here. Give me a second, everybody. Give me a second. I'm coming. I'm coming over there. Hang on. Don't run away. I'm coming. I'm coming. Give me a second. I'm coming over there. Shit, I forgot I need a glass of milk. I'm gonna drink milk today. By God. Alright. Oh yeah, big old glass of frosted cold milk. Oh yeah, that's kind of hot. Oh, that's hot. That was hot on my hand. Let's see here. Alright. Put my little coffee down here. Still got the green light. We ain't been locked in yet. So got plenty of time to talk. Plenty of time to talk. Y'all give me a minute. Y'all see a tornado yet? Y'all see the tornado? Yes, no, maybe so. Let's see here. Give me a second here. Where'd that little fucking thing go? Well, I don't know where the hell it went. I got one of them tornado warnings on my phone. It said, seek shelter. Seek shelter now. I don't know. It said, there's a tornado in your area. Maybe it's on the other side of the building. I don't know. Let's see who all's here, man. I know Sydney came in. Rashad, how you doing? Yeah, I'm batting down the hatches. Not nice and sunny in Oregon. The one day of the year that it's nice and sunny. So you're in with the cordon, huh? You're in with cordon or just in the super ego loop? Because I thought everybody coming in was now going under Floyd. Hey, Mark. Hey, Dan. So which one you under? Cordon or you're just at Super Ego and you don't know which one you're with yet? I like to mix my food up. All right. Now, since y'all can't tell what that is, these big ass chunks right here, that's chicken fajita. See the stripes on it right there. See? Chicken fajita. I mix it up with my super duper buttery mashed taters. Never lets me down, man. Never lets me down. I'd like to point out that it was bone dry when I got her. I got her. Just a microwave, Sydney. And Mark, it tastes good. Oh, you got one of them used ones? What'd you get? I've already been through this twice. The shit came down real hard when I was in Walmart shopping this morning after I dropped off my Coca-Cola load. Man, it was ugly. Lightning everywhere. Boom, thunder. Really scary. Then it eased up. Ran out to the truck. Loaded up the truck with my groceries. Got my load. Started heading this way. Had to go through all this bullshit again. All the fucking way over here. It's catching up with me as it heads east. 190,000. That's 140,000 more than I got. You definitely broke in now. So how come you got a used one? What's the logic there? And tell me how much it cost. I guess the update is I cleared out of Coca-Cola. Got done. Y'all know that. Went to Walmart. Done my shopping. Now, come over here. Out here in Monroe. Actually, east of Monroe. Way the hell out here. Come way the hell out here. Pick up whatever the hell I'm picking up. I'll take it to Winchester, Virginia. Yep, going right back to Virginia. Golf ball size, hell. Big Lake. What are y'all doing down in Big Lake? There ain't nothing there, so there ain't nothing to tear down. Only thing I know of in Big Lake is a baseball field. At the high school. Well, $650 for 4 years is better than $650 for 5 years for a used truck. It was Coke. And Dr. Pepper. At the same place. Another compression station? Damn! AMAC had to go up to Rockford, Illinois and get his truck directly from the dealership. They hadn't got it to the office yet. Every once in a while they run out of trucks. They ordered 500 KWs this year alone. I think I've said that. Be picky, because once you get it, you don't want to take it back. Tank got a 2019 Peterbilt. About 250,000 miles on it. He loved it. Till that other truck run over it. Potato chicken for heaters, man. And that, sir, is how you do that. Drink the rest of my little old milk. You saw a pee today? Down in Florida, down in Florida, Ryan was shut down for the night. I'm not exactly sure where he shut down. It was like a pilot, Flying J. Might have been a rest stop, but I'm not sure. But wherever he shut down at, there were five of them motherfuckers right there, man. I don't know if there were five in addition to him, or he made the fifth one. And he said, if I remember correctly, him and another guy were the drive-ins, and there was like three reefers down there or something. I see them every day, up and down the damn highway. I'm constantly waving and shit. Ain't nobody waves back, sons of bitches. Yeah, this is a thing, man. When you get up over 1,000 trucks like this, man, you're gonna be seen somewhere. I see them down by the house all the time, too. Irritates the fuck out of me, because that means whenever I want to come out of the house, you know, I go home from my little home time, I come out of the house, I gotta fight with my own people to get loads out of Texas. I don't like that shit. Be nice if these people took a whole bunch of money, Serbian money and shit like that, and started buying out some of these, what do you call them, mega carriers? Buy out one of them, just one, just find one, anyone that's struggling, somebody, you know, some large company, buy them out. Take all their contracts and shit like that. Let us all know so we can go over there and get some of that. They can start selling off the trucks and the trailers, you know, as used inventory. Put a bunch of lease folks in those. If there's a terminal or two, grab them sons of bitches. I'd love to have like 6 or 8 terminals scattered around the, you know, the United States. That'd be nice, with showers, laundry facility. That'd be very nice. I'd be willing to kick in a few dollars for that. Figure out a way. And I can figure out a way. I can figure it out where, you know, it wouldn't cost the company anything except initially buy it out. We're still green. Sydney, I don't know, man. I have no idea. I heard from some that was 7 years old, some that it was 9 years old. There go the lightnings. Somebody really pissed God off this week. That's wind. I'm not being loaded. I didn't really have to fight the wind coming over here, so I don't know what the hell this is. Telling me there's a damn tornado, seek shelter. I don't see no damn tornado. That's just bullshit. I say bullshit. I call it bullshit. Call these people real quick. Hang on, I gotta delete some messages. This is bullshit. People sending me textical messages and I ain't got nothing to do with me. It's all in Spanish. I can't read it. I'm curious. Hey TV. I hate this old music. Luckily, we don't have to listen to it very long. They answer pretty quick. I can't let you listen to it because I'll get a copyright claim against the damn YouTube video. Hello, safety. How you doing? You know damn well it's me. Man, I just need to know if y'all gonna fire me over here. I need to know if I'm gonna get fired. Yeah, because of the ticket. You need to, no, that ain't even funny. That ain't even funny. You need to let a brother know. This causes anxiety. I might be old and laid back and stuff like that, but anxiety's still there. Okay. Let's see if nobody got jokes. Hey, Bob. Still with the green light, man. I don't even know what I'm picking up. I have no clue. Graphics, Graphic Packaging something or other international. I don't even know what they do here. I assumed it was paper of some sort, but that's just because the area, you know. I don't know. Now, holy cow, it's already 4 o'clock. By the way, I'm on time, man. My appointment's 4 o'clock. I done got here, got inside the gate, got a dock door assigned, cleaned out my trailer, blew it out, made sure everything was right, slid the tandems, and put it on the door. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, you got jokes, I know. You're just being funny. What's going on? Talk to me. Okay, well, I got the lawyers on it. They're going to try to make it disappear. Yeah, I don't play around with that stuff. That's why I got a perfect record up to this point. Yeah. Okay. I appreciate you. Thank you. Alrighty. Bye-bye. Winning. Alright, so we're not getting fired. James for the win. I can't help myself, man. I can't help myself. Hang on. It's 5 o'clock where? Where the hell are you, man? I know you ain't OTR. I got a ticket for speeding in Virginia. Now, Sydney, I wouldn't say my foot was too heavy. I would say I was tired. I had about 5 hours sleep, and it wasn't good sleep at all. And I had to get up and move real fast. I had a two-stopper in Virginia. You did not move to South Carolina, you lying sack of shit. Why? I think it's a felony to lie on YouTube. I'm just saying. I think it's a new rule. It's a YouTube rule. It's a YouTube felony. I can't believe you moved, dude. I cannot believe that. That blows my mind. There's no fucking way. And what the hell is there in South Carolina for you, man? Where'd you move? Cowpens or something? I mean, it's like South Carolina really is like the ghetto of the Southeast over there. Ghetto. North Carolina is like across the tracks, kind of upper. Yeah. No, I wasn't paying attention. I was tired. Wasn't paying attention. I was doing something that I can't say, because I'll take the fifth on that one right there. I'm not going to incriminate myself. Doing something I wasn't supposed to be doing. And I wasn't paying attention. I done wandered into one of those, what do you call it? Oh, okay. If they got land, I'm on my way. Y'all hook me up a little bitty parcel of land over there, man. Hook me up. I'm on my way. I know they don't allow houses in South Carolina. You can only have trailers. So I'll go have to buy me a single wide and put it out there. But I'm willing. I'm on my way. Just cut me out a little bitty part, you know, in a corner. Away from everybody else. I'm on my way. We'll call that Terminal 2. Yeah. We'll get us a little parking area right there. Have all the Super Ego trailers. You can bring your shit too. What's wrong with your truck other than it's a Navistar? Which is
the, well, it's really, I guess it's really not a Navistar. It is, but it ain't. I guess. I don't know. Besides the engine, what's wrong with it? Your clutch? Was it your clutch? Why is everything flooding into my mind right now? It's like, dickhead, you know there's something wrong with this transmission. No, I don't know. I don't know. But I'm about to have your back, buddy. We're gonna get you cranked. The clutch fell apart. I must have an amazing memory. Either that or you're being real good to me. You're just being real good to me. It's really not your clutch, is it? Good milk. Okay, now we gotta have some coffee with that milk. Wash the milk taste down. Well, I don't think I'm gonna get any more, son. We'll just put that right there. We gotta get you in the loop, man. Get you in the loop. How much are they gonna charge you for doing that clutch? Or are you doing it? You gonna do it yourself? What are you gonna do? You trying to save up the money? Do it yourself? What are you gonna do? Talk to us, man. Talk to us, TV. You've got our undivided attention. And while you got the undivided attention, I gotta make a phone call. Let me let it ring a minute here. One ring-a-dingy. Two ring-a-dingy. Okay. Hopefully she'll call me back. They fixed Miss Peggy's gym and seat. I was expecting about a $3,000-$4,000 bill, but it was just a little over $2,000. There go the lightnings again. Some of them are like this, and some of them are like this. Very scary day right now. Very scary day right now. Y'all stick with me. Y'all might see me going up in the air. Watch this little fucking design on this trailer right here. It says MTI on that trailer right there. Ryan Ader, how are you winning? What's winning? Oh, you're talking about the fixie. There she is. Hey. Did you go get your gym and seat? Why not? I love you more, son. Why is it? Your mama's crazy, boy. Stay away from her. Not. Okay, and? And they washed it. Get the fuck out of here. We need to polish up them headlights. Yeah. Are you? With what? There. Yeah, but how you got a drill? Exactly. Yeah, there's a drill out there. If you can get the thingy to turn where you can, yeah, there might be a problem there. Okay. I got you. That's not your fault. Mm-hmm. Well, how much was it? Yeah, you said it was, well, I'm not gonna go logging into the damn account to look and see how much. I was asking you. Did it fix the radio? Did it fix the radio? Yeah, well, only on XM. So no more noise, ride smooth. Did they replace a tire or just the tire management system? Just the sensor? Tires are good? Are you happy now? Mm-hmm. You are welcome. That's the benefits of this job. I make more money than you know what to do with, boy. Go do what y'all do. I just want to check in, see what time it was, see what it's all about. All right, and I got good news of my own. She said, "Don't worry about the ticket." Yeah. The safety manager said, "Don't worry about it. It's cool." Winning. Total fucking win. No. The lawyers are taking care of the ticket. I'm just not getting far. That was my thing. Didn't want to have to put a driver in the truck so fast. I want to do this at my pace. All right. You bet. Bye bye. Yay. $2,300 and we got her shit fixed. My shit's getting fixed. If these lawyers can get rid of this fucking ticket, make it disappear, then mine. I'm going to tell everybody about this thing that I got. I hate to tell y'all about a plan that's going to charge you $30-$40 a month. I think it's between $30 and $40 a month, and shit, because that. For some people, that's a lot of money. For me, that ain't shit. I waste $30 or $40 a day. But if they do a good job, like they say they can, and they say they do, I'm gonna recommend them. I'm gonna highly recommend them. I'll tell y'all about it. But I think it's called CDL Legal. CDLLegal.com. I can't remember if they called me or I called them. I think I might have seen them on the fake book. Seems like I used to pay about $6 a month for mine at both Martin and US Express. Seemed like it was real cheap or something like that. Real cheap. Maybe it was $6 a week. Fuck, I don't know. But it didn't seem like it was all that much, you know, and I never used it. Now I get to use it. Now I get to see what it'll do. But it also has roadside assistance and discounts on hotels and motels and all kinds of shit. Kind of like having AAA and a prepaid legal and a couple other things all combined and being a part of Groupon or something. Lots of little old perks and whatnot. So I went ahead and got it. Hey David, how you doing? All right, TV. Been in the shop for 2 weeks in Dallas, but took back up to get. All right. They're too backed up to get to it, so you're having it towed to another shop Monday. Gotcha. Ain't nothing but a clutch. Won't take nothing to put that shit together. It's a little 10 speed, right? Shouldn't have a problem. Come get you a free trailer, man. Only $40,000. Yo, you can't get a trailer any fucking where now. You had to get on a list to get a damn drive-in and shit. Just come right over, man. Sign on the dotted line, they'll hand you a fucking trailer. You bringing your truck in, you make the 90%, the 90-10 split. And you got all the fucking insurance and shit like that. You could use your fuel card, their fuel card. You could do your IFTA, or they could do your IFTA. Winning. You make more money than I will. That's for sure. Kevin, that, you know, I used to work for Merit, the Merits, Team Merit. Kevin is the male person, and of course Susan is the female part. They're married. That's the Merits. That's Team Merit. That you remember the Volvo I was in? Well, Kevin, he got in the Volvo when I got into this truck. He got into the Volvo. Just a little reminder for y'all. Well, Kevin consistently makes more money than me. I think his is, I think he brings home about $5,000 every week. He's on, yeah, of course, you know, they brought their own truck. But they're buying a trailer, just like me, the exact same trailer. He and I went same day to get our trailers from the same place. Got the exact same trailers. You know, he's buying a fucking trailer. But he doesn't have a $650 a month bill for a truck like I do, or month. Wishful thinking. Fraudian slip. $650 a week. Sorry. My bad. But, yeah, he consistently brings home $5,000 or more. He's a very honest guy, and he said it 2 or 3 times, so I believe him. And he doesn't... you know, he didn't get any help ELD wise, so he just running the fucking loads, man. Just running, boom. Big paycheck. So he would have a TV, you would have the similar situation with him. There might be like an escrow or something when you start. You gotta get plates. If you have the 2290 already, then you probably wouldn't have to pay for that. But hey, get you some plates. You have to get your plates, your 2290 out of the way. And and it doesn't beat your truck up. And you get to choose your loads. You get to choose where you go. Fucking awesome. And the Southeast is hot right now. Hey, Nicholas. Yeah, I'm live. I picked up to tell you I'm live. Yes, I did. That's good. That was a great comeback, man. They have... Okay. Yeah, well... what is it you always say? Just cause it's you know they don't know who I answered the phone. They have no idea. Yeah. Alright. I'll call you right back. Alright, bye bye. So anyway, 90-10 for him to make 5,000. His, I wonder what his weekly. Now we gotta start adding shit, don't we? All I need is my calculator, man, and I can do it. All right, 250 a week. What else did they take out? Oh, the trailer. I think they went up on the trailer payments, dude. I don't know how much they are now. Let's just say two. Well, they charge $25. Let's say $275. Let's say they went up to $275. Okay, plus. I guess that's about it. Truck, trailer, insurance. Why the fuck is mine so much? Truck, trailer, insurance. Give me a second. I got a way of figuring it out. I look at my last one. My last little old thingy Friday. Where's Friday? My last settlement statement. They call them statements. They don't call them settlements. Okay. All right. Truck payment, trailer payment, cargo, and liability. Yeah, that's it. That's the weekly. So, if the trailer's $275, let's just say it is, weekly that's $525 except for the first week of the month. The first week of the month you pay more, because that's when you're, hell, that's when the insurance for the truck comes out. The bobtail and the comprehensive, the physical damage, that's $450 a month. And the ELD, no, that's $440 a month. So $525, let's remember that. $525, $440 plus $150 plus $40 for your trip pack. That's $630. And what do we say? $525 plus $525. On the first week of every month, you would pay $11.55, and the rest of the time would be $5.25. That's your fixed expenses. That's your fixed cost. $11.55 and $5.25. That ought to be real easy to remember. So $5.25. That's trailer insurance, and cargo liability insurance. That's three insurances and a trailer payment. Okay. Okay, so if you gross 7,000, which is incredibly easy to do, what's 11.25? What's that? What's that, Ryan? 7,000 times 0.90 is 6,300 minus the 525. That's $57.75. So that's running like I do, grossing about what I do, but you don't have the $650 a week truck payment. So there you go. How about that? I don't understand. What's the $11.25 there? What's that, Ryan? We're still green. They're not loading yet. I guess they're in the fucking tornado shelter or something. Week one. Is that what we figured out it would be? Or that's what you figured it out to be? K. because we got that email from AMAC. What? But it only, I don't know. It doesn't say anything about buying a trailer. It says trailer rental, doesn't it? Have you talked to a, TV, have you talked to a recruiter? Because if you haven't, don't. I'll give you my guy's number. You call my guy. Because my guy will handle up on it. He handles up on his business. Good. I'm gonna send you Tom's number right now. Don't call him right now. Two reasons. One, he ain't in the office. But two, and most important, he will call you every day. Wondering when. You can tell him, I'll be there next Monday. He will call you all weekend long. You don't want to start this until you're ready to do this. You heard me? I'm serious as a heart attack. You don't want to start nothing. Hold on. Pump the brakes. That's all I'm saying. Hold on. All right, TB. Well, it's easier to talk when you're driving down the road like this here. Okay. $295. So $11.75 for week one. So like $545 weekly, and then the first week is $11.75. Okay. It still sounds gooder than a motherfucker. Well, he hadn't, so kind of a non-issue. Damn it, boy. Nah. Okie dokie, Smokey. All right. That was the Ryanator. How the hell am I supposed to search? Oh, there it is. I'm having a hell of a time finding your shit, man. There you are. God dang, that took a... Okay, here we go. There's that. I sent it that way. Crap. Did you get it? I sent it on the messenger, man. Oh, you got it? Good deal. Yeah. Tom makes everything happen. He's the all-in-one recruiter. He talks Serbian really fast, I guess. I'm not real sure how all that works, but he makes that shit happen. Oh, no wonder it's so fucking hot in here. I had the heat turned up. Damn. I thought I was getting that fever again. Son of a bitch. What a dumbass. Okay. I feel like I keep losing money in the stock market. I feel like I need to move some shit around. Where is it? There it is. Okay. How long have I been here? Trying to get my little tracking device up here. See? 1 hour and 37 minutes so far, and counting. But an hour of that don't count because I was an hour early. But I think the storm has passed. I can see the clouds moving like that too, and it's getting lighter over here. But maybe that tornado decided to go over there. Leave me alone. Let me get my little load on or what have you. Ugh. But that's good news, isn't it? Everybody's got good news, man. It feels like it's a really good day all the way around, doesn't it? I got a pretty positive attitude. That's a win. I ate real good. I gotta go to the bathroom now. I don't see no porta potties. Guess I gotta wait. And I don't think I'm gonna be driving through the night. You know what? It would be okay if I put the address where I'm going right up in here. See how far we are. They said it was about 1,000 miles. We will see. Boy, they are eating my clock alive, man. And I don't feel like driving at night. I don't feel like driving in the nighttime. 19th. That's Friday. 8 o'clock in the morning. Man, shit. I'm gonna drive at night. I don't want to drive at night. Where is it? There you are. I forgot. What state is it? Virginia. Okay. 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 2:30. 2:30. 220, you dumbass. You no-seeing dumbass. 220. Yep. Can't read my own damn writing. And it's big, too. Park or something or other. Park Century Drive. But people can't spell, that's why. I already know which way it wants me to go. I don't even want to go that way. Oh, Jesus Christ, Mark. Need some milk. Put that milk on it. Can you throw a little chocolate in that milk? Just a little bit, you know. That'll knock everything down, man. I make everything feel good. All real cold. It's got to be really cold. Ice cold, man. Just goes down. Just makes everything feel so good. Yeah. Gerd be running from cold chocolate milk. That's what I heard. It's in the American Medical Journal. It's a surefire way to help you out. You just worry too much, Mark. You really do. You got way too much worry going on in your life. Just don't worry. Hey, just don't. It's nothing. It's walking apart. This is easy stuff, man. The hard part
about what we do
is the first couple weeks when you're driving down the road and you got a pass and there's a truck over here and a truck over there and you're scared shitless to go between them because you think it's like the movies and they're gonna move in on you. That's the only thing you're scared of, and that's only the first couple weeks you drive. After that, you start developing your confidence, getting your confidence up and shit, your skill level. Shit. Yeah, you need that milk. You need that chocolate milk. Maybe some Pepto-Bismol. I don't know. I'm not a doctor. I lie about doctor shit all the time. I don't know nothing about it, man. I've never had acid reflux, GERD, or anything. I've never experienced any kind of digestive issues. I've gotten stopped up before. Ate too much cheese pizza, cheese, macaroni and cheese, all kinds of cheese, and it stopped me up and I can't shit. You know, and then when I do shit, it's too damn big to go out my butthole. Yeah, I've had that happen before. That's my only digestive issue that I know. I can't think of a digestive issue that I had. My people decided whenever I was young, because I was such a picky eater, they decided there was something wrong with me. They took me to the doctor. The doctor didn't even look at me. I'm going to tell you right now, I remember going to the doctor, and they told him what they thought was wrong with me and shit like that. He's like, nah, the boy's got tonsillitis. We'll get him lined up for surgery. They took my fucking tonsils out. There wasn't no test. There wasn't nothing. They just took my fucking tonsils out. Well, I don't foresee me getting it. What happens to me has nothing to do with my digestive system at all. That's pretty tough. My problem is what I put in my digestive system tends to get into my arteries and clog up my heart. So I have clogged up arteries and clogged up heart. Tends to not pump as much blood as it's supposed to. Tends to make my arm hurt, have chest pain, feel like I'm gonna die. Pretty sure. No damn will. This is the end, Elizabeth. I'm coming to meet you. I'm coming to see you. For real. I just clogged my shit up with a bad diet. And smoking. I was smoking. I shouldn't have been smoking. I detested smoking my entire life. I detested it. My mom smoked like a chimney, man. I hated it. I used to light her cigarettes. I thought that was cool. But otherwise, I detested smoking because it stunk. I didn't like it. I never, ever, ever, ever had one of those, you know, bunch of guys, you know, hiding behind the fucking barn or school or something smoking and shit. I never had that experience. Never had that. Never. Hell, my mom would have bought my cigarettes for me. She didn't fucking care. She's stupid. Still stupid. But there was Tammy, see? Tammy was really cute. She had the prettiest eyes. Boy, she was so cute. But I couldn't get her alone to talk, you know? You're still trying to quit. Oh, shit, Mark, I'll tell you how to quit. we'll go over that. Dr. Ferguson's surefire cure for smoking. It's easy. But I couldn't get near Tammy to talk to her. Her stepdad was our supervisor. This place, you know, where we was working, we were drivers. And she was living with somebody. See, she had a boyfriend, and he kind of liked that boyfriend. So yeah, he wasn't going for that. And a lot of guys were hitting on Tammy. She's pretty hot, little old something, you know, really pretty, really cute, really pretty eyes. I wanted some of that Tammy business bad. And I noticed she goes out regularly and smokes Marlboro menthol. And I'm like, I can handle Marlboro menthol, I'm pretty sure. I think I can. So while nobody was looking, I eased on out there. I bummed a cigarette. I said, let me slip you a couple of dollars, you know, for helping me out and shit like that. And got to talking to her when we were out there smoking. He couldn't say nothing about us being out there smoking. Hell, he went out there smoking whenever it was his smoke break. He'd take a little break from the little dispatch office there. He could see us through the window out there, but he couldn't hear us out in the bay where we were. He couldn't hear us. So I was talking her up, smoking a cigarette, getting to know. Pretty soon, I would leave and I would go one way, she'd leave and be going another, and then all of a sudden we meet in the middle somewhere, jump in the back of her little van that she drove to go pick up the mail. I was in a big truck going to pick up the mail. We'd meet somewhere, jump up in the back of that van, and just go after it. She brought blankets. She brought blankets to work. That went on for a while. And the only way I could talk to her while I was there that she felt comfortable was if we were out there smoking. And I developed a habit. Now, the surefire way I stopped, because long after Tammy was gone, and I'd already met, married, and was about to divorce my second wife, long down the road, I'm still smoking. And Peggy, Miss Peggy, comes to me and she says, if I buy you the little vaporizing pen, will you try to quit? Yeah. Fuck yeah. So she went and bought it. It was $99.95 for the little kit. Came with some little e-juice, the pen, the whole fucking nine yards. Whole fucking nine yards. And that was my teaching tool. That was my learning tool. I learned on it. What I learned was, instead of trying to use said pen as an alternate for the cigarette, because you gotta alter the way you think with your brain. When you feel like you need a cigarette, you wanna reach for it, and you wanna roll down the window a little bit, light up and shit, smoke while you're driving and all that, reach over, grab your little pen or your vaporizer, whatever you do, and get you a little hit of nicotine. That's some good nicotine right there. That's a good tasting nicotine. It tastes so good. It's just going down. It's in the lungs. It's really good, right? Don't try to swap one for the other. It doesn't work. You have to just deal with the nicotine addiction first and step it down slowly over time. Dr. Ferguson knows. Over time. I set that pack of cigarettes and that lighter down. I put it right up there on the top shelf in the Canton house, and I never went back. Although I did open that cabinet door one day to get my coffee out, make coffee, I looked up and my cigarettes was gone. I'm like, ah, oh, shit. Peggy's mom done stole my cigarettes. That was a regular occurrence. Stealing shit is a regular occurrence right there. Well, don't. There you go. That's a good motivation not to smoke right there. That ought to help you get through this, man. Just deal with it. Work through it. Smoke occasionally if you need to. It's okay. Yeah, light one up occasionally. Just make it a time you don't want to smoke in the truck. Make it a time when you stop the truck and you get out and you walk over and you fucking smoke away from the truck. Is it hard? Peggy's mom smokes on the front porch right next to me while I'm live all the time. It irritates me. It doesn't make me want to smoke. It makes me want to get away from her. When she walks in the house after she's been smoking, I can smell her. She stinks. All of my clothes, all of them, even the ones washed, hanging in the closet, all my clothes smell like fucking cigarettes. I had to rewash everything 2 or 3 times. True story. I got boxes of clothes I don't wear anymore, and they smell like smoke. They smell like cigarettes, man. And they're washed. They got washed and dried, but they still smell. I can still smell it. I don't like it. It stinks. You get to that point after a while. Peggy's a militant non-smoker, but she never put any pressure on me at all. I give her kudos for that. She did it right. However she did it, she did. I know it's got to be a game she played. She's always playing games. She got her game down. She can't do nothing about her mom. Her mom won't stop smoking. It ain't gonna happen. All right, there we go. Yeah, that's enough. Ooh, that's cold. That's really cold. I don't know. I need to buy a truck, y'all. Not an oil field truck either. Not a little cash truck like that. I need to get something just a little bit more dependable. Run reefer. It's a little reefer loads. No big deal. Maybe put me an APU on that booger if it doesn't already have one. Just do it that way. Trying to make that engine last as long as possible. Oh, red light! Red light. Alright, it's happening. Y'all get ready. I'm ready. Okay. The thingy's in the trailer. I felt the dock plate go in, I heard it. Come on. Also, something I noticed the other night, my rivet line is really, really straight. It's real straight. But when I was loaded with that Sprite the other night and I had them tandems way the fuck back there, I could see a little dip in my rivet line. It's a little one, It's all the rivets, you know. They're about this far apart. It's just rivet, rivet, rivet. And I could see them, man. Just the rivet lines were dipping just a little bit. They're pretty straight right now. We'll see what happens. This is supposed to be a heavy-ass load, too. Like I was going to say a while ago, this fucking thing has got me going over here to 59 and taking 59 up. Through Chattanooga and Knoxville and shit. I'm not sure I want to do all that. I'm not sure I want to deal with all that business. I don't know how much it's gonna add if I just go over here to 65 and just go straight up 65 to like Nashville, well, right, you know, south of Nashville, but down around Murfreesboro or whatever, and do 840 around. I'd rather do that. I really don't want to deal with a heavy ass load in the mountains on 59. Now, if it turns out this is a light load, somebody lied like they usually do, then it'd be a different story entirely. I just don't want to crawl up those fucking mountains at 20 mile per hour, 30 mile per hour, 40 mile per hour. I don't want to do it. I just don't want to do it. I don't feel like doing it. Doing your mom. Come on, man. When I first got this load, I felt like it was going to be rolls of paper. That's what I had envisioned, rolls of paper. But I don't know. I don't know what it is. I have a feeling right now he's inspecting the hell out of my trailer, though. I feel like he's in there looking around. Got it kind of darked out, looking for holes, looking for leaks. Because it's clean. It's real clean. Because I blew all the shit out of here on their parking lot. It's really clean. Yeah, they said to clean, make sure the trailer was clean. I was like, uh-oh. I didn't clean it out over at Coca-Cola. Uh-oh. Houston. We're gonna have to clean it out when we get there. I am tired. I need to take a nap. Maybe that's what I'll do. I'll take a nap. Look here. See? That's what it did look like over there. See? The storms will pass. Yes. This too shall pass. Mm-hmm. So pretty. Boat. Damn it, boy. I think I'm gonna take a nap, y'all. I need to take a nap. Gotta clean my window off a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna snore a little bit real quick. Hopefully, they'll give me a call when it's over. And I can do whatever it is I gotta do next. All right. I love y'all a long time, man. I'm gonna have to go. I gotta go. And I gotta pee pee now, too. Man, I wish they had a damn bathroom. All right. We will see you down the road.